Good evening all across the country and here in northwestern Pennsylvania. Election workers are still counting the ballots, many of them tallying the mail-ins. Fox 66 is your local election headquarters. Chelsea Swift joins us now in the control room with much more on how voters see this and whether or not they're becoming impatient with a process that's now gone on for days. Chelsea.
Hi, Sean. Many people say the wait has been frustrating, though some say they would choose to vote by mail again for future elections.
Despite allegations of fraud and a days-long wait, expanded mail-in voting may have solved a long-standing problem.
A real expansion in terms of the number of people that are participating in this election. Mail-in voting is convenient for people. It's easy to do. They don't have to worry about getting up in the morning and getting to the polling place before they go to work.
And one voter agrees with Dr. Morris's logic. He says despite the delay in results, he would choose to vote by mail in the future.
It was too convenient. It was just really convenient. You know, showed up at our door. We dropped it off at the courthouse and it was just a piece of cake.
And his wife, Gretchen Petrorka, agrees. She believes this way of voting is effective.
Walk-in voters first and then go and open up all those envelopes. That would be good. But I think the way it's been done is very fair and every vote counts.
Some voters say despite voting by mail because of the pandemic, they would have preferred to vote in person.
I think it only makes sense to be able to count votes beforehand. That way we don't have this period of uncertainty. I think absentee is fine in the future. I would probably personally rather vote in person.
And some voters who declined to speak on camera expressed doubts about the outcome. They say votes should not be counted after Election Day. Sean?
All right, Chelsea Swift in the control room tonight. Thank you, Chelsea.